They're already demons. You hide here, Velvet. I'm going back to help Celica.
I'm so scared. Arthur, please.
You'll be just fine with these. Celica enchanted them herself. They'll give you the courage you need to survive.
They will?
Sure they will. Now, have I ever lied to you? I'll come back for you once Celica is safe. It's scary, but don't give in to fear. Don't despair, no matter what.
I won't. I promise. After all, I'm Laffy's older sister, and you're a student.
On that day, the world began to change. Men and beasts possessed by evil spirits, hunting and killing anyone they could. But even in the depths of despair, only two things matter to me. The taste of blood-soaked flesh. And revenge upon one man.
Laffy, time to wake up. Okay. Morning.
I told you to stop calling me Laffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good. Bit of a fever, I'm afraid. At least the new medicine's supposed to come today. Until then, you stay in bed, got it?
What? Aw, but I wanted to go to the Cape.
Sorry, you'll have to wait.
Can I at least read a book?
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
I didn't mean to.
Arthur, done chopping firewood?
Yeah, enough to last through winter. But there's something else I need to take care of. Sorry, but medicine money'll have to wait a bit.
I can earn it myself, then. Bring down a few prickle boars, and I'll have plenty to offer in trade.
On your own?
Arthur's first maxim. Plans must be solid and reactions flexible.
All right. I shouldn't doubt my students' abilities. Sorry to put you in a spot.
I'm sorry, Velvet.
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right?
Right. I'll see you later.
I whipped up some porridge for you, okay? Be back by evening.
Thank you. Be careful, Velvet.
Rest up.
Don't forget to take some gels with you.
I'll be fine.
Don't worry about me. I'll be in bed resting.
You better be. If I'm on the hunt for prickle boars, I'd better try the tranquil woods outside of town. This is for Laffy's medicine, so I can't mess this up. Come to think of it, Arthur hasn't requested his favorite dinner in a while. There's been so much going on, and the village always has him out hunting. Maybe he's just worn out? That does it! I'll cook him up some prickle boar stew, just like Celica taught me. That ought to pick him right up. A healthy portion of nourishing meat cures fevers and weariness alike.
Ever since the opening 7 years ago, this world's really gone crazy. Famine, freezing weather, and worst of all, this demon blight that's turning people into monsters.
I can't believe that people can really turn into those things. It's a nightmare.
Does no one know what causes demon blight? Or how to heal it?
No. What we do know is that when people turn into those monsters, I mean, demons, they gain incredible strength and attack humans on sight.
Whoever named it the opening named it right. It's like someone opened a portal directly to hell.
Come to think of it, Celica died during the opening, didn't she? It might be a good thing she died when she did. She didn't have to suffer through all of this.
It's good that my sister died? How can you say that?
Sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
You're a real idiot, you know that?
Sorry about him, Velvet.
Velvet. Is Lafayette feeling better?
No, not yet. He needs a little more rest, I think.
Aw, too bad. Tell him I'm looking forward to hunting beetles with him again when he's better.
Right, got it.
Lafayette's illness sure is persistent.
Yeah, that fever still keeps coming back, like clockwork. The medicine always helps a little bit, but still.
That sounds terrible. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help.
Thanks, but we'll be fine. At least we've got Arthur to take care of anything that needs muscle. And before he came, Celica raised me and Luffy all by herself. So now I have to do my best too.
You sound just like your sister. That optimism must run in the family.
I do? That's nice of you to say. I should probably stock up on a few things before I go into the forest. I don't have a lot of money to spare, but like Arthur, I'll...
The demon blight is a punishment. Sent to us.
Who are the Empyreans?
The four Empyreans created the world. The one Empyrean shall bring it to peace. Be afraid. When contradiction permeates this world, the time of suppression will be upon us.
Are you okay? Want me to take you home?
No! Don't treat me like a child!
All right, then.
Oh, it's you, Velvet. If you're going to the Cape, take care.
Don't fall into the Shrine of Tranquility, right? I know. I'm not a kid.
Of course, of course. You're 13 now, aren't you?
I'm 16. This area looks promising. There! Prickle Boar! Thank you. That's how it's done.
Cold weather's been terrible on everyone's crops, but at least the city will buy our prickleborn meat now. Luffy and Arthur have been hoping the village could start raising them, but they can just be so temperamental. I wonder if they could be bred with more docile pigs. What would we call them? Oinkleboars? Nah, doesn't sound appetizing. What about Piggleboar? Yeah, Piggleboar! That's a cute name. Maybe too cute, though. We wouldn't want to discourage people from eating them.
Where they're weak.
Thank you.
This should be enough to... I'd better bring these to the store.
This place isn't safe. That hole's gotten bigger. I've told them 1,000 times they ought to build a fence, but they keep saying it's forbidden land. Even Celica used to scare me with it. She was always, "This is a gateway to the underworld." Well, I'm too old to keep falling for that nonsense.
Wait, the boars I hunted, are you there? Maxim 3, never waver once your sword is drawn. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle!
powers.
An exorcist art.
Pride and anxiety. Pity for the enemy. Thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be your downfall. Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
Arthur?
Arthur's fourth maxim. Never let your guard down, even when victorious.
Got it.
In any case, this should be enough to buy Lafayette's medicine. I'll drop the prickle boars off at the shop before I head out.
Head out where?
The person I was supposed to meet is late. I don't think I'll be home tonight. I came out here to let you know. You'll have to pick up the medicine yourself.
Right.
One more thing. I saw a group of demons near the village. If you're attacked, run away. Am I clear?
No way! I can handle a bunch of...
Demons can only be challenged by those with the talent for exorcism. That's the cold logic of the world, and no emotions can change it.
Do you think I could become an exorcist?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
Why? Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
It takes a particular innate talent to be an exorcist. Unfortunately, very few humans have it within themselves.
All right.
Tomorrow is Celica's Memorial Day. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. I wonder if those prickle boars were brothers. Maybe I should have let them go. But then, how would I pay for Laffy's medicine? Hunting took care of that. And it means food for us as well. I had no other choice. It was a rational decision. But the fact that I'm still worrying about it shows that my feelings are getting the better of me. Nico, here for groceries?
Yep. And you must have been out hunting.
Yeah, it was a good haul.
Look at you, Lady Breadwinner. If you were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Oh, yeah? You ought to do something about your style, then.
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb.
So get a new one.
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Hey, mister! How about a sale on combs for the pretty girl?
Huh? Oh, you two need something?
I'm fine, Nico. I'm just here to pick up medicine for Lafayette.
Oh, Velvet. I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
What? Why not? Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight's really taking a toll on the city. There's even a group of them lurking around here now.
When's it coming, then?
I can't say. And I don't know how much it will cost.
Oh, no.
Ugh. What is wrong with Midgand?
But don't they have an army or something?
Those guys? The demons already routed them a while back.
But we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore. Poor fellow couldn't even protect his own wife and child.
Let me know when the medicine gets in.
Of course. For now, here, on the house.
Velvet! You didn't forget, did you?
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche.
You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your eye on? You were serious?
Beyond serious?
Please, this is life or death for me. But I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you dating.
Who cares what people think? The important thing is my feelings.
I like the way you talk. If I were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Darn right.
Luffy must be starving by now. I'd better hurry home. Orthy and Russ seem pretty down today.
I know. They've been whimpering like this for an hour now.
Well, they've always been a bit wimpy. The other day, that kitty Rollo chased both of them up a tree by himself.
They're hopeless. Whenever it's thundering out, they both dive into my bed, shivering.
Orthy, Russ, shape up. You're Nico's bodyguards, right? Start acting like it. They're completely...
Maybe... Celica taught you how to make your special...
Yeah, but mine aren't...
Don't be modest! They're fit.
That's because there's a secret in the cheese and the dough.
You should try selling them in Taliesin. We could make them together and take them on the road! We could even wear matching uniforms!
Would it make more money than hunting fricklebores?
Definitely maybe! Even more so if you could lighten up a bit in front of the customers.
Then it might be worth a try. I do want to buy Luffy a nice heavy winter coat... And Arthur's gloves are in tatters, so he needs new ones.
Oh, don't be so boring! I get where you're coming from, but come on! Think big! Dream, Velvet! Dream!
Think big? No thanks. I want a piece...
You're impossible. Then again, maybe that's what...
Thank you.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been 7 years since we lost you. And the baby you carried. Oh, drat. I forgot to bring your princessias. I know how much you, Mom, and Dad all loved those flowers. And I know your child would have too. I'm sorry. I'll pick some from the cape tomorrow.
Welcome home, Velvet.
Luffy, I told
you. I was only up for a little.
Look, your fever hasn't gone down a bit. Go lie down and I'll cook dinner.
I'm sorry.
What's this?
A compass. It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy, huh? Thanks to this invention, we'll even be able to voyage across the ocean. See? It's designed to stay level, so your heading will be true even when the ship is rolling with the waves. Pretty neat, right?
If you say so, Luffy.
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure. Can't you see how useful it is?
You can tell me more about it later.
Did they hurt you?
Not a scratch, and I brought back plenty. I can hear Arthur already.
Gosh, Velvet, I think it's time you learned all my secret arts.
He isn't coming home tonight, is he?
How do you know that?
Sarah stopped by and told me.
Arthur's Moloch? Huh, you really can talk to Molochim, can't you?
Yeah, Arthur says I've got exorcist potential.
No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him. I can tell you've been learning all sorts of things from his book collection.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the wonders of the world. I'll hunt and chop firewood, and if demons come for us, I'll defend you. I wish I could do that.
You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take... oh, 20 years tops.
It won't take me that long.
Oh yeah? You better prove it to me then. Start with this lovely meatball stew I cooked. Eat every last mouthful, even if you don't feel hungry. And take your medicine, no matter how nasty it tastes. No tricks, am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, cooking time. First, I need to light the stove. It's so easy to light Arthur's firewood. I wonder what his trick is.
Velvet? Could you not put any spinach in the stew?
Huh. You'll never grow up if you're picky with your food, you know.
I know, but just for today?
Fine, fine. I'll leave out the spinach just this once, and I'll make it that curry flavor you like.
Really? Thanks, Velvet!
There's some of Arthur's special curry spice upstairs, isn't there? There you go. Not spicy hot, but oh so delicious. Oh yeah, I saw Nico today, and she had very important things to talk about. She's coming over in the next couple days, so be on your best behavior.
I will. I'm glad you've got a good friend.
Yeah, we've known each other since forever. Still, Nico falling in love? I can barely wrap my head around it. Luffy, you know, If there's a girl you like, you'll tell Big Sister all about it, right?
A girl?
You're a stubborn little brat, so you might need an older girl to keep you under control. Oh, and she's gotta be a good cook. A pro in the kitchen is a success at life.
Knock it off, Velvet! You should be more worried about your own love life.
Me? I've got enough on my mind. For one thing, I've got to cook for you and Arthur since Celica is gone. Besides, getting crushes on strange men? I just don't see what's so... Luffy, what's wrong? Are you all right?
I'm fine. You just said something funny is all, and it made me choke a bit.
As long as you're okay. Sorry, I went off on a tangent there.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah, but what more can I do? I've got a duty to look after my little brother, and I'm serious about it.
I know, but I'm trying to look after you too. I want you to be happy. That's all. And it's not just me. Arthur worries about you too.
Well, we're family, right?
Yeah, that's what families do.
Thanks, Luffy. For you, I'd kill every last prickle boar in the forest if it came down to it. What am I doing? I need to hurry and get dinner ready.
The day before Scarlet Night. Sis went prickle boar hunting on her own. She's almost as good a fighter as Arthur. So I know those prickle boars don't stand a chance. But I worry that she's too athletic to land a husband. Maybe she should try to be more ladylike.
Little scamp. He just knew I'd be reading this, didn't he? Isn't this Arthur's book? Is Luffy really reading stuff this dense? Poor kid's gonna squint his eyes right out. Good boy. You didn't forget your medicine.
Well, I did promise. Tomorrow's a Scarlet Night.
Yeah, just like that night that changed our lives.
Velvet? May I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course. Okay, let's see. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? You better not have gone to the village alone. I bet your fever hasn't even gone down. Luffy's up in here?
No. I haven't seen him.
W-
Wait, that's one of Arthur's.
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Luffy, did he really copy all that by hand? Oh, he must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet! I saw Lafayette walking around. Is he okay?
He's not okay. Where'd you see him?
He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest. I know. He might have gone to the Cape to pick flowers.
Velvet, can you walk? How's your fever?
I'm fine. I was just taking a break.
Oh, you little... You know better than this, Lafayette. Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the Cape, and I thought...
You want to see the ocean, too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
Remember how we went out together to pick princessias on the morning of Celica's funeral?
Yeah. I was only four, but I remember. We couldn't find any in the village or at the Cape.
Right. Because the demons had made a mess of them. And then you suddenly started climbing down the edge of the cliff.
You ran over and grabbed me. You had the scariest look on your face.
Of course I did. Do you have any idea what I'd do if I lost you too?
You'd still have Arthur. He'd help you. He'll help the world. He's quite the guy.
That's probably true. But I'd still miss you like you wouldn't believe.
I know. I'm sorry, sis.
But down the cliff from where you were, a lone pair of princessia were blooming.
I remember. A gentle breeze came in, and it smelled like Celica.
That's right. That's why I believe those flowers were a message from her. Do you know what princessia flowers signify?
An irreplaceable treasure, and wishes for good health for many years to come.
Right. And that sums up my feelings nicely, Luffy.
Yeah. Me too, sis.
How about I make you some apple boo when we get home, Luffy?
Apple boo? What's that?
Grated apples. Whenever I caught a cold when I was little, Celica would make it for me. It's sweet and tart and juicy and crisp. Eating it always made me feel better.
Well,
apples are good for you. But what does the boo mean?
When I was a baby, I would always say boo-boo when I wanted to eat an apple.
So that's where the name comes from. Wait, you called apples boo-boo? You must have been a strange baby.
You used to do the same thing. When Celica and I heard you, we laughed so hard.
Boo!
Not bad. Look at all these. This place never changes, does it?
It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea.
Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today.
You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy. Do you know why it is that birds fly?
Well, if they didn't, they couldn't catch food, or escape from predators.
Thought so.
But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to...
A demon! Lafayette, run! No matter how much it hurts, run!
Velvet!
Don't be scared. You can do it. You're going to be strong, like Arthur.
No, you can't!
Go! Why is a demon here?
No, I don't want to go alone!
You have to! Don't let your feelings get in the way, or that thing will kill you too!
But please, go!
Arthur said,
I have to do this! did I get home?
Velvet!
Luffy, you're all right.
Sorry, it's all my fault.
No, if you weren't there, there's no telling what might have happened to me.
Your old one broke, right? You've got beautiful hair. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it. I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Scarlet Knight? What's going on? Was it all a dream? No, it wasn't! Time to be scared. I have to find Luffy. No, the village. Can't go this way. Boy, why is a demon here? Give up! Never give up! You kept Luffy safe, didn't you, Arthur?
One more sentiment to cast off.
Velvet, run! Arthur!
Here, once, was the seal to the underworld broken. And tonight, here shall be born the power to save the world. With Luffy's life as a sacrifice.
What? What are you saying?
let him go. This is an offering to the world.
Why would you?
Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see you have not changed. Ever a slave to emotion. Demon that feeds on demons.
Arthur.
A Therian.
Arthur!
Take a look around. Demon blight has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an exorcist, I, Artorius Colbrand, will end your pain. Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer, Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
I will make you pay!
So did my world come to an end. And for 3 long years, I sat in that pit of darkness and fed. Devouring demons. So I could live. So I could live long enough to kill him and be my brother's vengeance.
Where is he? First, there will be a test. It will decide if you are worth teaching.
Why are you holding back?
You noticed. Well done. You pass.
Of course. His Moloch would never be so weak as that.
I am his Moloch no longer. First, let me tell you what has transpired these past 3 years. There are exorcists now, throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of...
Tell me. Tell me where Artorias is.
You may find him in the capital city of Logris, in Midgand. You won't stop to listen. I can tell you what it was you saw that night. That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malakim descended, and with their strength, the emergent exorcists quelled the demon tide. Now, he serves as leader of the Exorcist's Abbey, an institution that enjoys the unconditional faith of the kingdom and public. A shield to guard the people and a sword against demons, Artorias Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafayette.
Indeed. But his power is not yet absolute. The man can still be killed.
Why are you doing this?
Make a successful escape from this place, and I'll explain.
Escape? So that's your game. Fine. I don't care what the world thinks of me. What matters is my vengeance against Artorias. That's all.
I have shattered your yoke. We must hurry. Equipment. There are weapons in the room ahead. No one raised the alarm.
I can see that.
Take what you need from here. It looks like they kept prisoners' effects in here.
Rope. This will be useful. Quite a blade.
I know that sword. Stormhowl! What is it doing here?
Well, it's too big for me.
You're not taking it? It's a celebrated masterpiece.
And if I can't use it, it's worthless. All right.
Are you ready then?
What's going on here?
Be careful. He's no ordinary soldier. He's an exorcist orderly.
Down like the sun! Burning wings!
You didn't even flinch.
I already told you. I am his Moloch no longer.
Is there a ship waiting?
So you already know we're on an island?
Yes. I've learned that this is a prison island for violent criminals, and that there are scores of demons locked away here. Demons say lots of things when they don't want you to eat them.
The prison has docks at both the front and rear entrances. Our ship is on the back side.
Got it. The back docks. What is this thing?
That's a special mass of mana. Think of them, they appeared all over after the advent.
Another after.
If you collect enough of them, you might be able to solicit the cooperation of a Moloch family.
And I'm supposed to take your word for it?
I'm not forcing you to do anything. Whether you collect them or not is up to you.
I might as well pick them up.
Indeed. You'll have to if you want your revenge. Guards coming. Two of them.
This way.
Did you hear? The path around the island is off limits now. They say the ground's weak and could collapse.
The path that goes under the watchtower? That's all right. Nobody uses it anyway.
True, but it was a nice shortcut to the docks.
A shortcut to the docks. Under the watchtower.
A number of guards have gone missing. It would seem we have intruders on the island. All exorcists, break into two groups and converge at the front and rear gates.
Understood. No one will get past us.
Stay sharp. The threat could be serious.
Yes, sir.
This isn't going to be easy.
Then we'll need reinforcements of our own. Where are the cells?
They should be on this floor. You plan on involving the other prisoners?
I'll use any tool I have at my disposal.
Who in the blazes are you? I'm opening every door to every cell. We're getting off this island.
What the hell? You serious?
Split into two groups and rush the front and rear gates. Break through the gates and you'll have a ship.
But aren't they guarded by exorcists? I mean, that pirate Von Eifried's the only one who's ever broken out of here.
And he didn't pull it off just by himself. He was hauled out by some old exorcist named Melchior or something.
Von Eifried? And Melchior?
I won't force you! You want to rot in here, then rot!
I'm with you. Anything's better than another day in this rat
hole. Let's do it. I'm going home to my family.
Me too!
Yeah!
Let me out,
Rogues
girl!
Rogues like us are always
I'm
up for a
I'm sick of the slop they feed us.
Ceres. That ought to draw the attention of the guards. In the meantime, we'll search for that watchtower. From there, we can follow the outer path down to the docks.
So you're leaving them all to their fates?
I told you. We'll use any tool I need. You're not going to escape?
Don't underestimate the exorcists. They're all gonna die like dogs.
or goblins.
This abbey that's in charge of this...
Amazing doesn't even begin to cover it. The exorcists of the abbey joined forces with the kingdom of Midgand. They've got the whole world in their pocket. They're merciless. They hunt down any human who becomes a demon. Going against them means taking on the whole world.
And I bet I know who's at the top.
Those who get captured and sent here are the lucky ones. We may be monsters, but at least we have our lives.
Sure, until they get fed to me. Thanks for the info.
Even if you manage to escape this place, thousands of exorcists controlling powerful Malekim will be out there waiting for you. There's nowhere for you to run. Nowhere.
I'm not going to run. I'll gladly die, as long as I take Artorias with me.
Dear me! Not a word of apology? People! There I was, sleeping like a sweet babe, when suddenly... From paradise down to hell!
No worse, a grimy prison cell!
You see why I'm not feeling well.
And you are?
Hooray! You asked! I'm thrilled to introduce to you the wise sorceress who travels the 11 seas, who scoffs at the might of dragons! None other than the acclaimed, the illustrious, Magi-Gigi-Gambi-Ludin-Dodin-Nolaroon-Do! Maggie Lou for short.
Maggie Lou?
No, Ma! Like Soggy Shoe or Doggy Do! Or call me any of those things and I'll turn you into a froggy stew! I suppose you'll never understand. People can be so tragically unlearned.
I can't believe she snuck up on me. Who is she?
This is no ordinary prison. We must be cautious. Trust no one. She said she's a powerful witch.
Did she have a Moloch tethered?
No, I didn't sense Malekim around her. She's an ordinary human, I think.
Then she's an ordinary magician, not a witch. If she tries to trick me again, I'll crush her and be done with it.
More?
This one. He's a demon!
Get ready!
You're not human.
Neither are you.
True enough.
Disruption! Disruption!
She's strong.
Chips in the blades already. Brittle, these exorcist knives. I've got to reclaim Storm Howl.
Storm Howl? That sword we found?
You found it? Where? Do you have it? Please tell me.
It's in a storage room. Down below.
Down below? You have my thanks.
He's an odd demon. If things settle down, we'll miss our window. Hurry.
Demon be...
What is it?
Nothing. That demon swordsman was just strange. He was so full of fury, but when you started talking about that sword, his manner changed completely.
Don't think too much about it. He's a demon, after all.
The prisoners here are all so unusual. Except for you.
Forget it. Like I care what a Moloch thinks of me. They've got the gate to the docks locked down. We can't break through.
The tower should be just ahead.
We've just about quelled this riot. You won't be getting away.
Come on, really?
The prisoners are doomed.
Time is short. We need to get down to the path.
The path has collapsed. That rope won't do any good here. Wait, you're not seriously going to try it, are you?
He fell further than this back at the shrine.
Thank you.
I see you are truly committed to this. You're strong. I would almost think you made an oath. It's a ritual that grants special power, if the oath taker abides by certain restrictions. The harsher the restrictions, the greater the power one may command. In a very real sense, an oath is a sort of curse, right? Well, guess what? You're the ones who did this to me. I am aware. That is why I chose you. We're finished here. Let's hurry on.
Getting out of here comes first.
Are you sure? This way leads to the main entrance.
If they know you're here, they'll have found your ship by now. The guards expect us at the rear, not the front. We're almost there.
That's enough.
Oscar, I had no idea an Exorcist Praetor had been assigned to this island.
You surprise me, Ceres. Aiding criminals now, are you? Did Lord Artorias request this?
No. I'm acting on my own.
A mullet with free will? And yet, I sense someone's strings guiding you.
Hold on. A praetor is far more dangerous than an orderly.
I'm all out of subterfuge. And besides, if we can't overpower this one, our end goal was hopeless to begin with.
You're a demon, but still a lady, so I'll show you due respect. I am Oscar Dragonia, Praetor of the Abbey of the Holy Midgand Empire. Who might you be?
Huh.
All right, graceless demon it is then. Lord Artorias himself taught me the ways of purification. How will you fare against them? Skilled. I will have to expend a Moloch or two for this.
More of your vaunted reason.
No!
demon blight?
It's lost control.
Wounds are fatal. Please, consume me. I'm not about to. My form is bound by an oath whose price is my life. The time has come to pay. Feeding on my form will grant you strength, the strength to press forward. I ask only that you devour me. Why? A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet. This was Laffy's. That is why I cannot abide it. This frozen world. This frozen people. I'm just that stubborn of a woman. Hurry. Before my life fades, do it now.
I offer no apology or thanks.
I need neither. Our wishes. Are one and the same. I treasured those days. When you and I and Arthur were together.
Move! If you don't, I'll eat you!
To wield as her own? I've never seen such a demon!
Thank you.
apologies, but I can't let a nasty demon like you roam freely now, can I?
Velvet! That's my name. You can give Artorias my regards. My name is Velvet Crow, and I will devour demon, Moloch, and exorcist alike! I am a monster! I am a Therian!
Tower. I thought, this is it, Moggy Lou. This is the end!
It would have been less risky if you hadn't suddenly appeared and jumped on my back. Oh, hey, it's you. It's thanks to you that Storm Howl is back in my care. Rokurodon gets it. At your service. This blade is my life. I owe you a great debt. One I vow to repay.
Yes, yes, she's a peach and a model citizen. Can we get our move on? I think they're just about done massacring the rioters!
The docks are just ahead. Give me a hand.
The weather's feeling as crummy as I am.
Careful. Sea's looking mighty choppy.
Are you a sailor?
No, but I do know the difference between a sail and a rudder.
I'll take what I can get. Do what you can.
You're leaving without a proper crew?
Very well, then. I certainly owe you this much, at least.
Brave words. But 10 minutes in this storm, and you'll lose all sense of direction.
No. We won't. Ships have compasses for a reason.
So it's rot in a jail cell, or rot in a fish tummy? Well, guess it's your lucky day, fishies!
I'm coming for you, Artorias. Luffy said, "A Moloch."
Ah!
Stay back.
Ah! adventure. You really are a box of horrors, aren't you?
Sorry. If I had a weapon, I would have helped. I promise.
You're wearing one.
Oh, nah, I can't use this. Sorry, long story.
And the child?
The little brat? Scampered off somewhere.
You ought to be scampering off yourselves.
My debt is not yet repaid. Until it is, I will not leave your side.
I can hardly scamper off without knowing from whence I'm scampering. We're lost, stranded, shipwreck survivors, no?
Well, then I expect this might come in handy.
A map? Was that left by the child?
Looks to me like we're in Northgand.
Northgand? Then if we're to reach the capital in Midgand, we've no choice but to patch up our ship.
What are your plans once you reach Logris? Something worth breaking out of prison for.
Can't we stand around and chat somewhere nicer? Somewhere with soup to warm the body, tales to warm the heart?
There's a city called Helavis nearby. I can't promise there much for conversation, but we'll find food and a ship right there.
Know that kid? I thought I heard you call him by name.
No, I don't know any Malakim. Not anymore.
Anymore?
What?
Well, whoever he was, there was something different about him, that's for sure.
You can say that again. Using healing arts on a demon without being ordered to?
And he stole that compass, too. For being an exorcist Malak, he's a greedy little imp.
Well, we did help ourselves to a certain map of his, so...
I consider myself an island of virtue in this sea of wickedness.
I suppose.
Come on, it's not funny if you agree with me.
You think?
So this is how escaped prisoners behave.
Magilu, your way of speaking is as strange as your appearance.
Hey, I'm a witch. I must project a proper age and dignity. I have an image to maintain.
Self-improvement in all things, I suppose. So what's the difference between a spellcaster and a witch?
There are many, but mainly it's a matter of nuance. It's like the difference between being frugal and being miserly.
Ah, so a spellcaster is useful and a witch isn't, is that it? So I guess that makes you a witch right now.
You wound me! You're one to talk, Mr. Self-Improvement! Your words cut deeper than these northern winds! Seem humanly possible.
I never said I was human.
Here I come.
Come on, really? Thank you.
Come on, really?
So nice to be free again. Able to move these bones around like I want.
So, Rokuro, what got you all chained up in that mold hole?
Ties to home. It's complicated.
Oh-ho-ho! Then are you really sure you ought to be taking on further debts?
It's a teaching of House Rangetsu. Pay what you owe.
Well, what a civilized family you've got.
Were you in for long?
3 years, maybe. That's why I know so little about the state of the world.
Me too! Art-wielding Malakim! I've never seen such a thing! How much else have I missed? Used to be witches who had a monopoly on charms and hexes. Can you even comprehend what this'll do to business?
Should I even ask why you were imprisoned?
Ha! Begged for unlicensed witchcraft. It was a tale of betrayal, most wicked and foul! Care to hear more? You'll cry. I'll laugh! Emotions will touch the rafters!
No, thank you.
Oh, no. I'm in so much trouble, so much trouble. Won't...
Oh, look, another...
That thing talks?
Simmer down, big man. She's just a cat. Haven't seen one in a good long while.
Cats?
It's complicated. Cats are a mysterious bunch.
That works for me.
Hey, I don't suppose you have... They look like this.
That's just like what I...
Perfect. You could say they're kind of like...
Cat spirits, huh?
Sometimes we call them kitten caboodles, too.
That's just foolish.
Really? Then how about kitty clumps? Anyway, one night we were having a feast. That's why I need your help to...
You meowsipate?
It means to use cat spirits to... Here you'd say apesipate. This one would be edogsipate.
I'm free.
See? Emucipate!
By that logic, shouldn't it be ecatsipate?
Wow, you're way more clever than you look! Please, our cat spirits got
Seek out the cat spirits!
And why should I-
Please!
You know, cats have weird and mystic- We'll make it worth your while, I promise! And, if we snub them-
That has been known to happen.
Ew.
If we're doing all the-
Just remember that it's on the side. Exorcists.
Well, that's just inconsiderate. Word of the prison break couldn't have traveled so quickly.
I somehow doubt they'll just let us in looking the way we do.
I apologize about earlier. I didn't mean to steal this.
The compass.
You okay with this? He could be working for the exorcists.
I'm following him.
Is he your dessert?
If necessary.
He must have gone this way.
There's a ladder.
A storehouse?
That smell. Flamestone.
Flamestone?
Also known as Melchionite, a rare mineral only found in Northgand. Mix it with sulfur and you get explosives! Mix it with oil and you get fuel.
Sounds dangerous, if it's true.
Believe me or not, it's your call.
Looks like the boy got away.
Well, we're in the city now.
Well, then let's scout for the Maritime Guild. Whoever's in charge of all these storehouses must have their hands in the shipping trade and shipbuilding.
And we could use a true sailor, if we can find one.
Now that's a plan I endorse! We dodged the sea's murderous grasp this time, but who's to say our luck will hold?
We should look for some weapons, too, if I'm to be any use in a fight.
You're still wearing one.
Nope, not an option.
Exorcist!
Me too! I want to protect my mommy and daddy!
Hold up! Exorcists are warriors who protect the whole world from demons. You can't just protect your parents. You've got to protect everyone.
Oh, that sounds really hard.
It is. And it's precisely because the exorcists are working so hard that we look up to them.
Yeah! Exorcists are the best!
They're treated like heroes. I suppose to normal people, they are. There's a group of sailors. Is that the guild?
Oh, hey, that weapon shop looks promising. Good luck with the shipwright search.
Boys, poor creatures just can't be separated from their favorite toys, can they?
It's true.
Thank you.
Is this a shipping guild?
Damn that dial! What does he think he's doing by trying to resist?
We wouldn't be in this mess if he were dead.
Excuse me. I need a ship repaired.
Sorry, but we can't help.
What makes you say that?
Guild business is currently suspended. By the order of Exorcist Teresa of the Abbey.
Lady Teresa.
Number two, did I give you permission to speak?
Lady Teresa, how long must this punishment of ours last? You know it was all Dial's fault, don't you, my lady?
I know Dial was the one smuggling Flamestone, but your guild, through its negligence, shares responsibility. This rule was set down by the Abbey to maintain order. Do you disagree with it?
No, my lady.
We will capture, interrogate, and sentence Dial. When this has been accomplished, you will be free to continue business. And you, girl. Aren't you cold dressed like that?
I've just arrived from the south. I wasn't aware Northgand was so cold.
A young woman ought to keep herself warm.
Thank you for your concern.
My, my. So this is how the Abbey flexes its muscle, hmm? Cruel, cruel world these days.
I see how things stand. If I catch this Dial person, you can repair my ship, right?
Sure, but I warn you, he's a demon. He escaped after killing a bunch of soldiers who tried to capture him. Can't be done without an exorcist.
He's from a small village outside the city. If you're doing this, I'd imagine that's a good place to start searching. He's a brute with the head of a lizard. I'd prepare for bloodshed.
Hey!
Anything could happen. It's best to keep our options open.
While you wait, find us a good navigator.
I wonder what darling Rokuro's got up to in the meantime.
Let's check in on him at the weapon shop.
Found a real good one. The blade was badly rusted, but once I polished it up, it turned out to have a fine edge.
I can scarcely believe something of that quality was languishing in my bargain bin. You've taught me quite a lesson. The weapon is yours as payment.
My thanks.
So you'll help us out?
Of course. How did your errand fare? I see. So we're hunting a reptilian demon called Dial, are we?
We'll check out his hometown first.
Have fun, you kids!
You aren't coming along?
I'm afraid I've got bigger fish to fry at the moment. That little matter of tracking down my betrayer. Besides, if I stick around, I'm not so sure I wouldn't wind up as someone's midnight snack.
My palate has standards. High standards.
All the more reason to skedaddle! Thank you.
Look, a yak. Hey, Velvet, here's a fun fact. Yak tail hair is considered to be among the highest quality materials for a helmet's plume.
Wow, really? Also, I don't care.
At my house, we had this helmet. It was an incredible piece, covered with yak tail hair. The talk of the town. House Rangetsu has two treasures going for it, people would say. The Helm of Yak and Storm Howl.
They must not have thought very highly of the rest of you.
Hmm? Why do you say that? Although, I guess I can think of a reason or two. Oh well, it's nothing a demon like me has to worry about.
You don't have to worry about getting attacked by demons while you're here in Hellavise. This town is under the protection of the Abbey Praetor, Lady Teresa Linares. She keeps us all safe.
Wow, she must really be something else.
She is. She's lauded as the frozen queen of the exorcists. She's as cool as ice and as pure and dazzling as freshly fallen snow. She's just the White Knight Hellavise needs. Our town is as beautiful and pristine as it is because we have Lady Teresa here with us. Anyone who disturbs her order, whether human or demon, will be frozen by her wrath, soul and all.
Sounds just like an exorcist.
The way she glares at the filthy. Oh, if only she would look at me like that, with those ice-cold eyes. Teresa, my love.
If she lets idiots like him run around loose, then I'm sure she's not as infallible as he thinks she is.
That was a good session, if I do say so myself. Tomorrow's drill will be even faster.
I thought he was being a crazy demon again, but come to think of it, this is just him being him.
Did you hear? That navigator for the shipping guild, Dial, he supposedly killed and ate his-
Demon Blight? In Hellavise?
No need to worry. Lady, she'll hunt down that Dial.
They say that once you change, you can never turn back-
Killing him would be a mercy.
Yeah, you're right.
Not human, huh?
Let me get this straight, Alpha Area. You want to correct. It's the classic strategy. Ally with a distant state and strike a neighboring one.
What is this? A council of-
The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Is that it? Indeed. If your Alpha forces and my Gamma forces work together, Beta Area is done for. I like it.
Excellent. We shall be victorious in this year's Hellavise Grand Snowball Fight. Let us toast to our victory!
This isn't a snowball fight. It's a snowball war.
Fools! I was the one who engineered their alliance. Once they eliminate Beta Area, the Alpha and Gamma forces will launch a full-scale assault to destroy the other. Exhausted, the victor won't be prepared when my Delta army sweeps down upon them. They have sealed their own doom.
These kids really fight dirty.
All's fair in snow.
Well, Hellevise is the cold snow and ice.
It's that...
Global cooling?
Yeah, that's the one. The Abbey says the world's getting colder.
Thanks to all this cold,
Who's responsible?
Well, don't look at me. What a beautiful ship.
Isn't she? She transports Flamestone and Sulfur to the capital in Midgand. Have you heard of Flamestone? Thanks to their discovery, we can mix...
explosives.
It is dangerous, but it's also necessary. Not only on the bright side, with a higher demand for Flamestone, Flamestone is the only reason our little snowbound city is thriving. A keelhaul to...
So this ship goes to the capital?
Nope, not happening. The guild... Besides... Any ship carrying precious ores hasn't...
Sounds like they keep a tight...
Yeah, I guess. But the... Without the Abbey, humanity would be dead and...
Nothing but ice and snow as far as the eye can see.
Are you cold?
I'm fine, but I'm not the one with the exposed midriff.
Doesn't bother me either. And watch where you let your eyes wander.
Hey there, sorry. I meant no offense. So you still retain feelings like shame then?
Wait, you don't?
Me? I've lost a lot of my human feelings. I figured that was just part of turning into a demon.
I didn't know that.
But deep down, I'm still the same person I always was. And I can still enjoy a good drink. I'm glad I haven't lost that, at least.
If you say so.
Don't get overconfident.
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
In my way!
Oh.
Don't waste my time.
They were nothing.
I unleashed all my power. Maybe I overdid it. Look, there's something growing all the way out here. That is one gutsy flower.
It's a princessia.
That's quite an elegant name.
My sister loved them.
I see. Thank you. And everybody's in position, I take it?
Yes. Preparations are underway now. We're all looking forward to it.
Not much longer. Keep up the good work.
Of course.
If anyone can succeed, it's you, sir.
It's nice, Elika. Time to do what needs to be done. For you, for him, for everyone. Is something the matter, Velvet?
Oh, no. I just didn't want to disturb you.
Perish the thought. You're not disturbing anyone. She's your sister, too.
I know. I just figured that, well, she loved you the most out of all of us. And that, you also loved her more than anyone else, so...
Velvet, there's no ranking among family. Celica, Lafiset, you. You're all very important to me.
Yeah, you're right.
It's almost the anniversary of her death. I better go to the Cape and pick her up, Princessia.
That's a good idea. I'm sure that would make her happy.
Yes. I really hope it does.
That snake Artorias.
They say flowers have different meanings and stuff, right? Any idea what princessias signify?
Betrayal.
Oh?
Not even worth my time.
On to battle. Sorry to cut you down.
Don't get overconfident.
I'll cut down anyone in my way.
On to battle.
Not even worth my time.
I see a village.
Let's go ask around.
I was here, but any further attacks and...
An exorcist? Was that Dial she slew?
No, it wasn't a lizard demon. Are you crying?
It's just... everything that's going on. Demons run rampant in the Outlands, and yet the Abbey has explicitly chosen not to come to their aid. It's true we haven't the forces to be everywhere at once, and the people of the Outlands refuse to obey the Abbey's rules. It's a heartless decision, I know, but it follows from the Abbey's perfect logic and principle.
Why make excuses to me?
I'm not making... My name is Eleanor Hume. I am a praetor patrolling for the Abbey. What is your business here?
We heard there was a murderous demon in this town, who fled from Hellevise.
The Shipping Guild incident, yes. I've been looking into it, but I haven't found any clues yet. Worry not. We will track down that foul demon and put it to the sword.
Did the exorcist lady go away?
Yeah, she's gone.
Oh, good. I didn't want us to get eaten.
Eaten?
I mean, I don't know anything about a demon.
It's fine. You can tell me. I'll keep it a secret. I promise.
There's a lizard demon in a cave to the north. He said he'd eat the whole village up if I told anyone. I'll give you these. Don't tell anybody, all right?
Got it. That's a promise.
A cave to the north.
Gotta say, the folks here really don't trust the exorcists, do they? This is actually rather good. What's wrong? A worm?
Nothing. Can't taste a thing.
Huh?
We learned what we need to. Let's look for that cave. That woman said she was patrolling for the Abbey. What's that mean exactly?
They're handpicked agents who travel the kingdom gauging the Abbey's success in the demon fight. They also make sure the other exorcists are conducting themselves properly. I suppose you could liken them to military police. Since the Abbey imposes so many rules on the populace, they want to show they're above board.
But if they need to police themselves, isn't that as good as announcing corruption in the ranks?
Some would say it's more honest this way. Idealism alone won't change the world. Maybe that's why our determined little exorcist was crying.
I bet you're right. That does fit the picture.
Although it's best not to take a woman's tears at face value.
Huh?
Just some common wisdom. That's one fine yak you've got there.
What an adorable face.
You might not want to lean in too close.
Hmm? Why?
That is nasty.
That's why.
Yaks ruminate the food they eat while they digest it. Their burps are one of the foulest things you'll ever smell.
Same as cows and goats. Everyone who's raised livestock knows that.
I think that point's been driven home. That's a smell I never want to ruminate on myself.
This village seems much more run down than Helavies was.
This is where the Abbey sends its malcontents. Don't conform or accept the Abbey's rules or commit a crime, and you'll end up here with the rest of the refuse.
And I take it the Abbey doesn't care what happens to this place.
So, disrupt their precious order, and you get banished?
Exactly. I'm sure they'd say it's all part of their notion of reason.
Oh yeah, that exorcist Eleanor said something like that.
After the Advent, the exorcist showed up to quell the tide of demons and to restore the human world. But demon blight keeps spreading, and the only places they can keep safe are a few of the bigger cities. There aren't enough exorcists to protect everyone.
When the going's tough, cut off any excess baggage. It's the rational thing to do.
I suppose so, but it's too heartless. And that right there, that's the Abbey for you. Humans aren't livestock, and we're not machines either. That's why some of us here, myself included, chose to live here of our own accord.
Guess there are all types of humans out there.
The important takeaway here is that exorcists are neither invincible nor infallible.
Wait. My granddaughter said she spoke with you.
Hey, hold up. It's not like we threatened her or anything.
Don't worry, I know. I gather you intend to continue your travels, yes? Then take this. It's nothing fancy, but hopefully it helps.
Food's ready. It's nothing special.
Ah. Hey, Velvet.
You can do whatever you want, but...
So, you can't taste anything?
Not entirely. I can taste blood.
Nothing else?
Nothing. And I don't think I can feel full, either.
You don't think? You talk like you've never had a good meal before.
I haven't. Not normal food, at least. Not since I became a demon.
So, what have you been eating?
Please. You were in that prison with me.
I'm sorry.
Forget it. This is just what I am now. As long as I have a recipe, I can still cook. And now I don't even have to worry about how it tastes.
I suppose.
Food keeps my strength up. That's all I care about.
Oh yeah, the guy at that weapon shop gave me some booze for the trip. I nearly forgot about it.
You really think it's a good idea to drink when we've got demons to fight?
A little drink'll warm me up.
I thought you couldn't feel the cold.
That's true, I suppose. Well, I'm not drinking it anyway. I'm using it for something.
Like what? Got some wounds to clean?
That's one use for it, sure. But I've got something more practical in mind.
By pouring it on the pegs that hold the blade and hilt together, the wood will swell and hold everything firmly in place in battle.
You've got such a one-track mind, I swear.
That's just the kind of demon I am.
Ready to fight.
Smell.
Oil?
You better be ready. my time.
You'll be rushed on my blade.
They were nothing.
Don't get overconfident.
Not even worth my time. We're finished here. I think we might be able to break this.
And people say I'm
I'm serious.
You have a point.
Better be ready.
They were nothing.
Thank you.
Don't waste my time. We're finished here. Let's go.
So it was tar we were smelling. Watch your step. You won't get out if you get stuck.
I'll end this quickly.
in my way!
Not even worth my time.
To battle.
We're finished here. Let's go.
Don't waste my time.
You know what they say, falling off a rock only makes us stronger.
I don't think that's quite how the saying goes. I'm going to jump.
Don't fall and crack your skull.
on to battle!
We're finished here. Let's go.
Don't get overconfident. See this? See this? See this? See this? Oh, stop.
We're finished here. Let's go.
Thank you. done this quickly. Go faster! You won't go this.
Victory is ours.
It's nothing special.
Are we ready for this?
You're a fine swordsman.
Not as far as I'm concerned. I still have a long way to go.
What sort of demon are you?
A Yaksha. I'm a war demon.
A war demon. Makes sense.
And what about you? You're awfully peculiar, even for a demon.
I'm a Therian.
Therian? That's a new one for me. What sort of demon is that?
A monster that feeds on foes to gain power. I don't know much beyond that.
Hmm. A woman who devours her enemies. I bet your demon type is hag. Am I right?
What?
Whoa. You've got the death glares down at least. What sword style do you use? Who taught you?
I'm self-taught.
For being self-taught, you're really good. Your fundamentals are solid, too. But then you suddenly throw out these kicks and all these other moves. It's really unusual.
Like I said, it's my own style. And what about you, huh? What's with those two swords? You say that big one is your life, yet you never even draw it.
It's best that I don't.
Huh?
Is that part of what you learned at House Urangetsu?
Yeah, we pay our debts. That's the foundation of everything we do.
I don't get it.
You'll be rushed on my blade!
We're finished here. Let's go.
Don't waste my time.
Victory is ours.
You'll be rushed on my blade.
They were nothing.
You'll be rushed on my way.
Better be ready.
I'll cut down anyone in my way.
You said you can't taste anything. How is your sense of smell?
Why do you ask?
Those two senses work together. You know, like how if you pinch your nose while you eat, the flavor goes away?
If anything, I think my sense of smell has improved. What about you?
All my senses are sharper now. Still, being able to smell but not taste. You said Eutherians eat demons, right? Not what I'd call a pleasant diet.
Look who's talking. What do you eat?
I drink, mostly.
That doesn't sound pleasant either.
Nonsense. There's nothing with more depth and variety. Every ingredient, every process alters the whole. The rich, complex flavor dancing across the tongue. The mellow aroma exhilarating the nose. But what would a child know of such things?
Whatever.
The only downside is, now that I'm a demon, the stuff goes to my head faster than before, too.
Now that you're a demon, huh?
Always ready to fight!
We're finished here. Let's go. An exorcist.
Did he slip and fall?
No, he was thrown in!
I won't die yet.
Not until I have my revenge.
Revenge?
The bastards at the guild who tried to kill me. They want me to take the fall for their smuggling operation.
Wait, are you saying the whole guild was involved?
Of course. You think a second-rate sailor like me could pull off all that mischief by myself? I mean, sure, I was in on it. Helping them wasn't without its benefits.
He has a point. It would take more than one person to dig that tunnel into the warehouse.
Problem is, our extra-legal activities were a little too successful. The Abbey was bound to notice us at some point.
And dead men tell no tales. So they blame it on you and kill you to cover it up. Looks like it's not going quite how they planned.
How do you mean to get this revenge of yours?
A raid on Hellevies. I'll kill the lot of them. This I swear.
That would be suicide. Do you have any idea how many exorcists are around?
They'll hunt me down no matter what I do. I just want the guild to pay for what they did to me. That's all I wanted. But I guess even that's not gonna work out.
We'll take this back to town and tell him you're dead. That should be enough to satisfy the exorcists and get them to call off the search.
But why?
I have my reasons. We need a boat fixed, for starters. Plus, if you stir things up after I leave, I imagine it'll slow down anyone who's following me.
If that's what you want, miss, I won't let you down. By the way, how on earth...
Luck.
The village I grew up in was the dullest, gloomiest place ever. But look at me now.
I see.
Is this really how you want to play it?
Listen, I'm being hunted too. It's only a matter of time. I can't afford sympathy.